Today we're going to talk about index contention. Probably index contention is the most common form of contention that we see in any Oracle database. And the most common form of contention we see on indexes is usually a primary key index that's being populated using a sequence. And the reason being for this is that we are experiencing high transaction volumes, each one of them creating a brand new record, and each one of them generating a sequence number. And as a result, because they're basically ascending values or keys, we basically, when we do the insert into the index to maintain the index structure, we have to keep walking down to the right-hand side of the index tree, and then everybody's going to want to maintain the most right-hand leaf block in the index. With that in mind, so everybody is focusing on one page of memory and wanting to maintain that page in memory. And this is a classic form of contention. Now, the reality of the situation is that only one person can modify that page of memory at a time. So everybody else that wants to modify it needs to wait. And that's the contention. Now, we are talking about it in a very conversational way, assuming things working at human speeds. But you do have to bear in mind that actually we can actually change pages in memory thousands of times per second. But the reality of the situation is that we're very often wanting to do transaction rates at higher than just thousands per second. And so this is why things show up as contention. And with that in mind, I'd like to show you some things associated with index contention, how to mitigate them, how common solutions and sort of folklore solutions to the problems associated with index contention may sound great in a meeting, but actually in reality fall apart fairly quickly. And what we're going to do is we're going to take a very simple workload that we've been running in other real-world performance demos, and what we're going to do is slightly modify it to initiate index contention, and then we're systematically going to work that contention out of the problem, but we're also going to scale up the system and make it bigger, and we're going to make that system run not only on just one computer, but we're going to scale it across a rack cluster. So, in this workload, you can see that we're running here is a very simple gaming transaction that we were running before. You can see the response time is steady, the transaction rate is steady. We're spending quite a little bit of time logging because it's a small transaction, but the rest of the time is on the CPU and we've made the machine quite busy. Now what we'd like to do is we want to actually get more information from the application. So the application developers have created a brand new history table to collect every card dealt in the game. And what we're going to do is create a flattened structure of every card dealt and every decision made by every player in the game, and we're going to put it into a big history table. Now, that big history table is then going to be indexed on a surrogate key, which we're going to make the primary key, so we can effectively mark each row as unique. So very quickly, I'm going to put in, from running no indexing, and to put a B-tree index on this additional bit of code. So we're doing an extra insert statement, but that insert statement is on a table with a primary key index using a sequence populated. Let's look at the impact on performance here. As you can see, it's quite dramatic. The response time has shot right up. The throughput has come right down, and you'll notice that the characteristics of the system have changed quite dramatically. From running at 60% utilization, we've dropped to 20% utilization, and we're now experiencing a lot of Oracle database contention inside the database. We're seeing buffer busy waits and TX index contention. So let's just sort of think about this. Although we've added code path to the transaction, and we've almost doubled the code path in the transaction, the CPU has got less because we can't run, because we're contending inside the database. As a result, we're not running and we're not using the CPU, the transaction rate drops and the response time increases. So at this point in time, we've got ourselves into a spot of bother. If we had done this over a weekend, we'd suddenly finding that our gaming site is running at a fraction of the transaction rate, and we're probably starting to lose gaming people who are wanting to play the game because the response time is so bad, they'll take their business somewhere else. And this is all because we basically extended the application to do one extra insert into a new table that had a primary key using a sequence. So in terms of solutions for this, and you can go and research on the web and through manuals on this, there's a lot of solutions out there. And what I'd like to do is go through some of the classic solutions that we see always being suggested and actually evaluate them, see how they work, and then let's critique them and see how good they would and how robust those solutions are. So one of the first things we always go when we actually demonstrate this the audience will always say, well, why don't we just build a reverse key index on that primary key? Because then you'll have mitigated all the contention and will spread all the maintenance, the full width of the index. So let's do that. Let's build a reverse key index on this structure. And let's see what happens. Well, you can see fairly quickly, the game is changing quite quickly. We managed to get the transaction rate up to almost half the level of where we are. So we're now running again back at CPU speeds, okay? So basically the transaction drop between here and here is associated with the additional code that we're running, and we've managed to mitigate a large amount of the contention in the index associated with the workload. As a result, you can actually see that the CPU workload has come back up again. Okay, so we're getting the CPU up again, and the response time has improved. Okay, so you can see at this point in time, we appear to have solved our problem, one of contention. We can get the CPUs busy, the response time is better. But there is a problem with reverse key indexes. And the challenge associated with reverse key indexes is what happens is when that index becomes bigger than your Oracle SGA buffer cache. Then at that point, we're starting to incur IO maintaining that index. So I've already built one of these history tables pre-populated to a very large size. Let's have a look and see what actually happens when we have, say, ran this application for a couple of weeks, and now the history table is getting quite big and we've got a reverse key index in place. Again, you'll notice that the performance is starting to degrade, and in fact it's degraded a lot more, or marginally more, than when we had buffer busy wait contention on the index. You'll notice that the AWR report or ASH reports are now showing the biggest wait event is based on read, you know, doing a physical I/O to reread those index blocks back inside the application into the buffer cache. It probably also fact that this index is now so massive, it's displaced all the other blocks associated with other tables and index in the application or other applications running in the same database instance. We're probably degrading other applications as well because they're incurring more physical I/O. But again, as you can see, after a period of time with a reverse key index, we've actually degraded the performance to worse than when we started off with just having in-memory contention. So to think about it, we've actually got different forms of contention coming in. And an in-memory contention was actually cheaper than having an on-disk wait event. So we've replaced one wait event for a slower wait event. And that was just because basically those blocks couldn't all fit inside memory. And remember, we can access structures in memory in microseconds, whereas we're now having to do physical I/O and referencing those blocks in disk is going to take milliseconds. And the difference between microseconds and milliseconds, that's 1,000 times faster. You can see quickly why the performance has now degraded to less than when we had in-memory contention. So I don't think we want to do that as our solution moving forward. It's one of those situations where the guy who made the smart move 2 weeks ago is now being called back to rethink their idea. We've showed that basically running a B-tree with a sequence can cause in-memory contention. We've shown that a reverse key index can eventually cause us to do too much I/O, which will slow the application down. So the next solution that's often suggested is to use one of partition the index. Let's break up the index into lots of little bits by hash, such that instead of having one hot contention part at the right-hand side of the index, how about we have lots of little warm spots rather than one hot spot? So let's apply the hash partitioned index to this problem, and let's see if it can mitigate all this I/O, and let's see if we can get the response time back, and let's get the CPU back up in. And you'll notice we've to a certain extent, we've achieved it by a hash partitioned index. So within a single instance, we've now got to the situation where the hash partitioning has mitigated all the performance problems on the insert. Now, in the real world performance group, we were always nervous about using partitioning as a means of solving problems associated with contention. The reason for that is multiple, okay? One is no guarantees that it will actually work, and we'll show that moving forward. And the second one is by partitioning objects where they weren't partitioned before, we may introduce collateral damage. I'm sure people have partitioned up tables and then suddenly found they can't get the same execution plans or something else has degraded on workloads not related to the insert. And so going in and actually partitioning an object to solve a contention problem carries inherent risks, and we call this just collateral damage. We may damage a lot of the performance integrity of other aspects of your application, reporting, other queries, or even other transactions. So we're always nervous about recommending partitioning as a solution for contention. What we prefer to do is think about engineering a solution to engineer contention out in the application layer. We were reluctant to partition the objects as a means of solving performance problems associated with contention. One, because we don't believe it works that well, although it appears to work quite well single instance, and secondary, the collateral damage that can be done. So let's think about that in terms of, let's take this current single instance system and take it up to two nodes. And by taking things up to two nodes, we're going to double up the number of connections to the database, all doing the same gaming transaction. But we've still got the hash partitioned index. But let's see what happens to the performance profile and the throughput as we double up the amount of equipment or amount of hardware, and let's see what the throughput is. Well, the first thing to notice as we go to multiple instances, you can see that the CPU on both nodes, on what effectively is the new node, has come up, and it's the blue one, but actually the CPU load on the red system has actually dropped. Okay, the thing to notice that the increment in performance at a throughput level was almost non-existent. Okay, likewise, we've seen the response time increase, and now we have a whole new series of wait events inside the database, all as GC buffer events. Okay, so by literally, even though we have a hash partitioned index structure and we've got now moved to two nodes, what we look like, we've got ourselves into a scaling solution. Now at this point, we don't actually have a serialization problem because we managed to divide the workload amongst all the hash partitions in the index. But what we have is a scalability problem. And the reason being for this is what I hinted earlier, is the speed of access of blocks. If you can reference that index leaf block that you're wanting to modify and it's within your own buffer cache, you can modify it in microseconds. If you have to request to go to another instance and apply cache fusion to bring that instance across, that block will take a millisecond to come across the wire and then to be into your buffer cache that you can then modify. Now, as you add nodes, the statistical chance of you finding that block inside your buffer cache disappears. So with two nodes, we have a 50% chance. You can see that if we go to three nodes, we have a 33% chance. If we have four nodes, we have a 25% chance. So as we add nodes, it becomes harder and harder to get locality of data within your own buffer cache. And this locality becomes extremely more important because modification of a local buffer is 1,000 times faster than modification of a remote buffer. So you can see, even whilst we've done hash partitioning, which is very often the traditional response, and it'll even be get suggested by ADM reports when you see index contention, it doesn't solve the scalability problem. It solves the contention, but it doesn't solve the scaling. To get scaling such that you get performance pro rata with the amount of hardware you use, we need to get some more cache affinity and to ensure that the blocks are modified and kept within the instance that we're actually changing the block. So the final solution when making index maintenance scalable not only within multiple CPUs within a single instance, but also as we add instances in a rack cluster to make that insert statement scalable, is to ensure that we basically are able to get some cache affinity local to the instance. Now, like all real-world solutions, we believe the solution is not associated with tuning and fiddling around with the storage and the space on the tables and playing around with parameters such as initrans and stuff like that. The best solution in all real-world performance problems is to move the problem space up the stack more into the application. And for this problem associated with index contention, if we could control how we generated the surrogate key and generated the surrogate key in an intelligent manner, we could actually start to build in all the features that into the key generation to ensure that we not only get good cache affinity to help rack scaling, but also we could spread the keys around such that we don't get contention within a single instance. So in terms of index contention, we actually have two challenges. We have inter-instance contention or scalability problems, and likewise we have intra within an instance contention and scalability problems. So what we have to do is start thinking about building a smart key. So a smart key would very often be going back to a line in the application code and actually figure out how would we generate a series of bytes that we know won't contend. So one of the first things to think about doing is how about leading the beginning of the key with the instance number? This will effectively redirect all inserts down to a side or to a portion of the index that is basically going to be the where that index gets maintained, the cache where the index gets maintained. So if the leading bytes contain the instance ID, which can be queried through SQL, we can start building some cache affinity associated with the insert. The second challenge is then when having located yourself within an instance, we need to make sure that multiple processes within that single instance don't contend for the same piece of memory. So if the middle bytes of your sequence or your intelligent key were, say, something like a mod of the process ID, we would effectively be able to hash the maintenance of that index across multiple in-memory blocks within an instance. And then the final set of bytes would be your sequence number itself to ensure the referential integrity component and making sure the row is always going to be generated unique. So what we would actually end up with is either an intelligent key or a composite key, of which the composite component, all in one set of bytes, would consist of the leading bytes being the instance ID, very often a mod function of the process ID logged into the database, and then the final bytes to ensure uniqueness. So let me just show you the situation is when we use a scalable key on a large index at this point in time. So and see if we can actually make the scalability challenges associated working with the cluster disappear and get the response time down and get the CPU utilization up on both nodes. And as you can see, having gone and modified the code further up the stack and changed the key generation, we're back up into being able to get 2x the performance because we've got twice the hardware. The response time is coming down. You can see that the CPU utilization on the machine has increased and now is steady state. And we're getting to a similar profile that we had when we ran earlier when we were running contention free, i.e. we're running on the CPU and we're spending time waiting for logging. This is a scalable solution as well as a high performance solution that gives good response time.